In the last video, we showed you how you could have an automatic animation happen and went from something into something else. In this video, we're going to be creating an animation that we can toggle with a button, and it's going to take just very, very minimal changes to our already existing code. So let's get started on that right now. So what we're going to be doing in this video is toggling a little bit with styles. Now, this isn't really anything crazy here, but it is going to be a little bit different than we have going on with this fade. Now, we have a menu and we have a button. I'm actually going to throw this in a separate component. Just for fun here, we're going to have a new component because I want to be able to get rid of this stuff, but you know, you can keep this code in your examples here. And we can just go ahead and call this toggle.js. This is going to be a React functional arrow component. Let's see, React functional arrow component. There we go. And it's going to be named toggle. We're going to import React from React, but we're also going to be importing use state as well. And we're going to be bringing in some stuff from use spring as well. So we have a div here. Let's go ahead and just have what could be an H1. That's just going to be something like hello. And then we can have a button. Let's see. It looks like my auto completion is being very finicky right now. So that's unfortunate, but no worries. And we can have this just be toggle. Okay, now if you have used React hooks before, you'll know it's really easy to set up a very simple toggle here where we can say const, and then we're going to say is toggled, and then we can have the set toggle. Okay, and this is going to be equal to use state. Now, use state is simply just going to be our hook where it passes in the default state, which is going to be set to false. Okay, now we're not going to be using is toggled quite yet because we're going to want to animate this on, and we're not actually going to be removing it from the DOM. We're just going to be changing its appearance. However, we do want to throw in our set toggle onto this button here. We can do on click is equal to an arrow function where we will set toggle to the opposite of is toggled. Okay, simple like that. It's very, very simple toggle here. Nothing crazy, nothing really that important. We just are toggling this value and we should have our set toggle is toggled. Let's go ahead and throw our toggle itself into our app.js. We're going to import toggle from /toggle. Okay. And we're going to be using this down here. We're going to be making a main tag, main like this, and throwing in our toggle like so. Okay, so check it out. We just have a basic main toggle. We're importing our toggle. Everything should be looking sort of like this. Now, granted, the hello is black. We could go ahead and make those changes to the CSS if you really wanted to. This isn't really code that's going to be sticking around anyways. You could see click toggle. Hey, it does nothing. No biggie, because we want to be animating this. To make this a little bit easier to read, we could actually head to our CSS if you want. We can do CSS app.js. We can just say H1. Color white. This is a let's go ahead and just have this a little bit easier to see here. There we go. Okay. This is just a temporary example here. So don't worry if this isn't going to be anything too crazy. So we have our hello. Now let's go ahead and bring in our spring. We have worked already with a spring once, so you'll know that we need to bring in a couple of things. First of all, we need to bring in use spring. And we'll also need to bring in animated. Okay, so that way we have our divs or whatever we're going to be animating. Actually, in this case, it's going to be an H1. So a little bit different there. So we're going to bring these in from React Spring. No big deal. Now I'm getting a red underline here in my linter. I think it's just confused, to be honest. I think VS Code is having a problem right now. So let's not worry about that too much. What we do want to worry about is how we can use Spring here. So we're going to say const. And we're also going to name this fade because we're going to do a fade in once again, okay? And this fade is going to be equal to use spring, okay? Now, you might be tempted to come in here and do the same thing we did, a from and to property. However, we're not going to do that this time. We're going to be doing something that may seem a little bit interesting to you. We're going to say opacity right in here. So this is our to property, as in this is the end state. When this thing mounts, there's not going to be a from thing. So there isn't going to be a property in the from state. So whenever you think about this from and to stuff, it's important to think about the from prop always, or the from property, I shouldn't say prop, the from property of this object as being the thing that its initial state is before it or at when it mounts. And then it mounts and then it animates to the to property. However, if you do not have a from property, it just starts at the to property. So we don't need a from. So that's good because we want opacity to be 0 if the toggle is false and 1 if the toggle is set to true. So we don't need to have a from and to property. You might be tempted to do something like that, and other animation libraries do work like that. What we actually want is we want to go ahead and check our is toggled in here and say, hey, if this thing is toggled, we're going to go ahead and set this to 1. Otherwise, set it to 0. Now, this is really fascinating because what useSpring does here is it will animate between these two states now. So we won't see this thing in action until we use our animated. So let's go ahead and take our animated and turn this H1 into an animated.h1. And then let's go ahead and have our style be equal to fade. And we should be able to see this thing in action. In fact, by the time we head over to our code, what we're going to be seeing is that the opacity initially is set to 0 because the fade is toggled is set to false. So when this thing first initially loads, is toggled is set to false, useSpring comes in here and it says, okay, the value for opacity is going to be equal to 0 here. And then when we toggle it, it's going to be kind of magical, but this thing is going to actually transition. So watch this. Beautiful. Look at that fade. So it's really super nice. This is not mounting and unmounting, so it's not a transition. In fact, transitions in React Spring are a little less elegant than this. However, this is pretty fascinating because it didn't take us very long and it was really easy to get set up. And now we have this basic fade in, fade out. Now, granted, this is just happening when you're clicking a button, but, well, we have a menu up top here. You'd expect when you click this button that a menu might come in, right? So you'll see instantly that this kind of animation is very, very possible to do with just a basic useSpring. And this is just the bare bones basics of what we're going to be getting into later. But it's important to know here that if we have an actual event happening here that we want to change the value, we simply just need to do so like this. Now, there's a lot of other things you could do in here as well, and which we'll be getting into in the next video when we talk about animating some more complex properties than opacity, because opacity is a number, and it's really easy to say, hey, go from 0 to 1. But is it easy to go from a color of red to black? Is it easy to go from a pixels to whatever? I mean, there's just a lot of different things that you might be animating. Maybe it is transform properties, which is something I would assume you're going to be animating quite a bit. Let's get into in the next video talking a little bit about more advanced versions of the same useSpring with different kinds of values here. What kind of stuff can you actually animate in React Spring? Okay, so as always, this is Scott with Level Up Tutorials. Follow along in the next video as we make this demo just slightly more complicated and talk a little bit more about these values that can get plopped into useSpring.